Good evening, everyone. It's Chris again, here in Columbia River Gorge in the Multnomah Falls in the Troutdale Hood River Corbett region on Highway 84, making my way to a destination where there's a stranded motorist. Actually, it's a motorcycle, not a motorist. He needs to be rescued. And we're on our way now to try to get him some help. We're going to try to tow him away from his predicament and get him where he needs to go. So with that in mind, stay tuned, watch the rest of the video. because the front steering posts, you know, they're nice and fancy. You don't want to put anything except a soft strap on them, and you have to have a secure soft strap that's strong enough. This is rated at 5,500 pounds. This is rated for 10,000 pounds. And this kinetic rope, believe it or not, I've probably done 15, 20,000 pounds with this guy. I don't know how it's possible, but it's synthetic. So if you got really good kinetic rope, you can use it. I'm just making a knot here. We're gonna put the soft strap to use. The customer is gonna be riding this thing up the hill. I'm gonna peel that cardboard off, if you want to point to this cardboard, because that could get slick. Once we get them onto the bed, we're gonna tilt the bed back flat so he doesn't have to go all the way to the very top. And then we just cruise it to the front, okay? So, a couple more setups. Bed again, because it doesn't tilt. This is hydraulic. This is like 8,000-9,000 pounds of pressure. But you want to make sure you lock it. And again, this has to be flat. Okay, so find a place. Yeah, it's sticking quite a bit. Yeah. A little bit of work on it, but it should be okay. Thank you. the bike strapped, well, at this point it's propped against the winch plate, so it's supporting momentum forward. We got the forks strapped with two 3,500 pounds, basically automobile straps. They're wrapped around the upper fork assembly, away from any cables, any hoses, anything else. It's compressing the forks down slightly. The bike is sturdy. It's also in gear. We've got also the fairing and the handlebars kind of strapped, but we're protecting just the balance left and right. It's really just, as you can see, these are loose. They're not pushing, putting any pressure onto the onto the plastic. There's just as an additional support. We've got the support here around the inner fairing, inner frame, that's wrapped around balancing the bike from this, from going this way, and on the other side the same thing. We got the tire. We're gonna put one more strap forward and one more strap back, and we should be good to go. Got a number of straps. Got the fairing, not the fairing, the forks, upper forks strapped away from the fairing. Got the handlebars and handle support strapped loosely, and then we block the fairing so that way it does not touch the fairing. We got the inside frame supported and secured. We got the rear tire. By the way, our shuttle van is, the battery is down or something. We're gonna see what's going on over there. And then we got the upper, the other side of the motorcycle secured as well, obviously crisscross. The rear tire, inside frame support, again, a little bit of the upper fairing, and then what's going on over there?
It's not turning on.
Oh, you left the battery died or something.
I don't think
I got jumpers, so I'll get you.
But I don't know why, because I think I turned it off.
Okay, we'll take a look at it. Anyway, we're all ready to go, so we're gonna take off here in shortly. Separate unit away from, I guess, my vehicle. And the reason for that is the customer obviously couldn't ride along with me because of our insurance protocol not allowing passengers in our tow vehicles, especially for such a long distance. And so we have made accommodations for shuttle transport. At this point, we're en route. We're about 150 miles away from destination. It's approximately 7:50, 7:40, a little bit after 7:30. And we should be there within the next few hours. Clear path all the way to our destination and make our delivery quickly and safely. With that in mind, keep watching, and I'll show you how we unload the motorcycle off the trip. So as we're still continuing in our journey to deliver this motorcycle, we made a stop over to fill up and get some more DEF fuel and diesel, because vehicles do not move without fuel. And so we checked our straps and checked our tie downs and everything else. And guess what? We found part of the casing of the engine block that apparently the motorcycle, that was a part of the motorcycle. So The area when we inspected the motorcycle at the time of pickup, it had a tremendous leak. The customer claims that it's transmission leak or possibly transmission issues. Well, I believe it's a lot more than that, because a corner piece, almost like a chunk of the engine, interior engine block, you know, during the transfer or the vibrations of the road, loosened up, and it was just laying underneath the motorcycle. And it's literally the size of maybe, if you take a, I guess, a meatball, imagine a meatball, but a corner aluminum chunk from the engine broke or was broken at some point, because that's what caused the leak, and it just loosened itself up and dangled between the fairing and fell down underneath the motorcycle. So that suggests that the motorcycle has sustained more than just a transmission problem. Oil is coming out from the engine compartment through this opening, this corner opening that basically broke apart. And we made it here with this motorcycle perfectly in position. We're gonna unstrap it and get it down slowly. That light's on. Anyway, just want to show you right here is where we found underneath that little component that broke off, and it's likely from right inside the engine compartment.
Look inside there. Right there, that little chip right there, that piece, the corner spot right there, that's broken off the engine block and it fell down on the ground. And so that's its culprit.
Okay, for you guys watching at home, customer's bike is down on the ground, and we use the strap, 3,300 pound strap. If you've seen me anchoring it earlier, I got it with a soft shackle up in the front here on the front of the bike. It's secured. Now it's going to be unsecured, and it's sitting on its own kickstand. The deck is still tilted, and we're going to pull the deck straight forward. Shackles are loose, strap is loose, and we're gonna pull the deck just like it sits forward away from the bike, so it's got clearance, unless the customer decides to move it like he did. Anyway, so that kind of concludes this trip. Thanks for watching.